Good morning, friends. It is a great day for all of us when children who now are going to make up the promises and the sign for the Lord. It is a great day not only for the parents, but it is a great day for us as a church. The Orthodox service has a recording day where a real part of our conversation part of our campus is followed by the community. During the community, we request the candidates and the parents to come to us, followed by the rest of the candidates on this special occasion. Can you take note that the servant will not be there? The beginning will be after the confirmation, that is the only change in the order of worship. The announcement of this morning is written on page 24. Since during the service we do not have an announcement, but let's keep going. There is a special meeting of the diocese council to be held on Saturday, November 12, 2022. Kindly keep the diocese, all the prayers, and all the representatives of the church in your personal prayer. There is going to be a remembrance day service here. Thank you.
Do you think instead of the and so that you can make it amazing for others. Otherwise, you will be staggered over the face of the Holy Spirit. But the Lord may come, Jesus, and the Lord, the Lord said, He, as one person speaks the same language, they have been able to do this, that nothing they plan to do, this is impossible for them. Come, let us go down and continue the language, so they will not understand each other. So the Lord scattered them from their course of all the world, and they stopped praying. That is why Jesus is called Father, because there the Lord removed the language of the whole world. From there the Lord scattered them over the face of the whole world. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. If it is to lead, do it diligently. If it is to show mercy, do it cheerfully. This is the word of the Lord.
Okay. desire to be confirmed must first confess to our teachers in Christ and to the rejection of all that is given. You have already accomplished the course of being a disciple of Jesus Christ. He says, if anyone will become my follower, let them deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. But he also promises that in his company, those who are too hard to hear. I will ask some questions here and then you will have to answer them carefully. Do you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? Do you therefore renounce all that is given? Do you follow Jesus Christ in the fellowship of his church? With the fellowship of faith? You are in the life of the new followers of Christ and to renounce all that is given. The power of the truth is promised to those who hold fast the God of faith and hope. Do you believe and trust in God the Father who created you and all the world? Do you believe and trust in His Holy Spirit to renew and transform you and all the people of God? Do you believe and trust in His Son, Jesus Christ, who has redeemed you and all the world? He promises the sincerity of our faith is true when it is active in love. I therefore urge you to make your daily life full of the power of all who loves you and has made you into children. For your Son died for you and for your Spirit dwells. It is right to bring your prayer and reading of the Bible to grow in God's love and return to you for your life. Do you strive to respond to the grace of love of God by your life turning to the gate to you and observe your life? Will you join as well as possible with your fellow Christians in public worship on Sunday, and especially in the Lord's Supper? God calls His church and shares all people the good news of His love made known to Christ. Will you take your part in doing this? Let us pray in silence that the Holy Spirit may enable you to be faithful to your promises.
Amen. Thank you.
at the level of sin. I would like to nominate those who have been confirmed that step up in the blessing and the confidence of this and acknowledge committed members of this esteemed congregation of the St. Thomas Cathedral of Diocese of Cornwall, the Diocese of Cornwall. At this juncture, I pray to our Lord that He may keep them and guide them and provide all kind of wisdom, knowledge, amazing grace, and such a confidence is virtue, skill, they are great children, beliefs, and their destiny. May God bless all of you. Now,
by the
say, I think for Narcissus, I never noticed that Narcissus was I think because each time he lay beside the bed, I could see in the depth of his eyes my own deep reflecting that I think. What a lovely story is this. Keeping in mind the same story, we will look into the parallel of Narcissus and Taxpayer, which is the name of this one. Here, in this parallel, we found two characters, one which is sent. Righteous and other sinners. The Pharisee stood himself and prayed, Lord, I thank you that I am not like others, but robbers, evildoers, adulterers, or humans like this tax collector. I trust. And keep a day for all our day. If we look at this character by the side of God, he's a self-righteous one and drawn to self-pride and self-righteousness. He is impressive by the side of God. Which God is that?
Thank you. gathering of all leaders at the climate change conference in Egypt beginning today. The great families in mourning. May the Holy Spirit guide Martin Chief Justice, Justice Chandra. This is speech for the Church of England and Archbishop Justice and Stephen. The Diocese of Marathwada and Bishop Kappa. And the Diocese of Krishna Godavari and Bishop George. For proceedings at the Diocese of Council and our representatives, Mr. Satya Solomon Raj and Mr. Premana Devote. And all celebrating their birthdays this week, Amelia Knox and Sharon Ravichandra. Page 19. Everlasting God, open our eyes that we might see. Open our ears that we may hear. Open our mouths that we might speak your praise. Lord, in your mercy. Holy God, we pray for your church throughout the world, for skeptics and believers, for clergy, high and low, for all those who seek God at home, at work, in the streets and in the streets, for all who search for life. We pray for the stillness to listen to the voice of the Spirit and to recognize what you have done for us. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Merciful God, bless Vijayanagara, our Vikram, Dharmaraj, moderator of the Church of South India, Theodosius Mahatma, the metropolitan of the Mahatma, Sharad Raiwar, the moderator of the Municipal Commissary, the Diocese of Bombay, for Avinash, our President, and all ministers of your Church, that by faithful proclamation of your word, we may build on the foundation of the apostles and prophets into a holy temple in the Lord. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Creator God, you give to us the care of our planet, and yet all that we seem to do is spoil it. We pollute the atmosphere and we bring death and destruction in senseless wars and acts of death. We pray for a time of common sense soon and we all learn once again to be good stewards of your wonderful creation. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Father God, we pray for the Tanya George, Priya Rebecca, Alina Mother, Olivia Tamasha Raga, and Amitika Levy Roberts. Dive with the promise to your Spirit when they meet this troubling and challenging world. Fortify them with your strength. Help them to pray and faithfully serve your word and the sacrament of communion. Help them find their hope in your Church so that they, together with all who believe in you, may confess your name and in words and deeds both thank and serve. Lord, in your mercy. Loving God, we raise before you the sick and the suffering and ask that even in difficult times we may honor you and encourage others by our prayer for those who are unwell. We pray for Mr. Alan Moses, Mr. David Roberts, and others in this world. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Gracious God, you give light to those in darkness who walk in the shadow of death. So remember in your kingdom, your faithful servants, that death may be
concentration, the common prayer is given to me. It is going to be right. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord God. It is going to be right.
Thank you.
Father,